beauty, you know, you can find beauty in what other people would think would be kind of a bleak scene, or maybe humor and beauty. The things I find beautiful are not what other people would find beautiful. For instance, flowers can be beautiful, but a brick wall can be beautiful too. It just depends. My name is Tim Olson. I'm an artist living in Dubuque. And I was born in Storm Lake, Iowa. And I grew up on a farm outside of a little town called Marathon. Looking back, I had a pretty good childhood, but my parents didn't have a very happy marriage, which when I was a kid, I didn't really care. As long as you know, I got what I wanted. But they stayed together until my younger brother was out of high school. Well, when I was young, I was really interested in art, and my older brother was kind of a drawing and painting prodigy. He really influenced me a lot. But I was really interested in photography, because of course I didn't want to copy my brother. A lot of the work I was doing when I was in college, I would take photographs on the farm and with my family. It was very personal in that way. And my parents, I would say they pretty much led separate lives. Maybe part of what I was doing was trying to kind of capture the weird family dynamic that we had, which was normal to me. So I lived in Los Angeles for a couple years, which was not a great experience. But after that, I lived in Chicago, which I really loved. But in both places, I didn't really connect or didn't know how to make art there or interpret the city around me. So I didn't really have a connection.
Tim and I met back in 1993. We were working at Hedrick Blessing, which is an architectural photography firm in Chicago. He was in the production room and I was a black and white printer. I work in historic preservation, so in a lot of ways, Tim and my work overlap a lot with his love of history and my love of art.
I think a big point for me is when we moved from Chicago to Dubuque, and that's when I really started to see how I could use Iowa, and in particular Dubuque, as a subject.
Physically, the architecture is beautiful, like people talk about. They're connected to the ocean or they're connected to the mountains, and here I feel like I'm connected to the view looking over the Mississippi.
I really love folk art, and I think I use that as a lot of inspiration. It's a little bit cartoonish. Academic messiness, that's one thing I came up with.
There's a lot behind it. It's kind of like watching cartoons with your kids from the 1950s. The adults see a lot more in that cartoon than maybe the kids do, but they both enjoy it. Photography is really important to him. He calls himself a picture looker.
I guess you'd call everyday photography, like school pictures and mug shots, and those things I brought into my work. The series of paintings I've been doing lately are based on paintings from the past. These are two pieces that will be in the show in May, and they're both triptychs, and they're both based on older paintings. The bottom one is based on an icon called the Hospitality of Abraham. And then the top one is based on a triptych called Three Scenes from the Life of St. Catherine. I think the original was based on a dream or a vision that St. Catherine had. So this is my updated version. Chris keeps me pretty well grounded with advice, like on even just on little things?
I would probably say that I am Tim's strongest critic. He'll show me a painting and I'll say, well, that figure's not working for me. And he'll look at it and he'll just take a razor blade and go whoosh, 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 and wipe out the figure. And my response is usually like, oh, I didn't mean get rid of it.
You know, right now I'm working on a body of work for a show in Sioux City that's gonna open in May. A piece I'm working on now, the Seven Deadly Sins at the Super 7 Motel. So I spent the last couple weeks painting and firing the stained glass, and now I'm working on the frame. So when it's finished, it will be a light box. And then in each of the rooms will be one of the seven deadly sins. So I was preparing for this show, and I had just finished up a couple of restoration jobs. So in the fall was gonna be my big push to get things finished. My father, he was in a nursing home. My mother was in an assisted living, both in Dubuque. So they're divorced. They're in different places. So for the past 3 years, you know, you're going from one to the other. But in October, they both got sick at the same time, which has never happened before. My dad, you know, in October went into hospice and then passed away here, and my mother now is in hospice.
You know, with his parents, his mom has been sick lately, but she's even asking about his art. She's asking to see pictures of it. I don't think his dad really ever got it, but they've always been involved.
As a farmer, he really likes things that are built well. You know, so if I took him to a show, he would look at the frames. Oh, you know, I really like that frame. And then I took him to my show in Dubuque here. You know, I don't know if he liked it or not, but yeah, his comment was, I like the way that you fit everything into the picture, you know, which is not, you know, that's not easy. Sometimes you make things too big and it go, I guess that's what he was talking about.
So Tim did a portrait of his father by creating different portraits of him sitting around the same room. And he put it together in a string. And that was sort of his style back then, was to be able to take black and white pictures, mark them up, put them together into sort of a panorama, but one also that played with reality.
I remember he didn't want to do it. So he said no, and then maybe half an hour later he said, okay, if you're ready, I'll do it. But I love this photograph for a couple of reasons. For one, it just documents the way our house looked at that time. I think this is right after my mother moved out, so the house had a very sparse feeling, you know. My goal when I'm making a piece is just to make something that other people wouldn't make. When you're an artist, you have to remember, nobody asked you for a, you know, a painting of the seven deadly sins in a motel. You know, I always think when I'm doing a piece, like a stained glass piece, oh, this is gonna be it. This will be the thing that will really break through. That's not how I would define success. If I did, I would be in bad shape.
You know, I remind him, you're not here to make art to make everyone happy. The kind of art that he makes is not really for the masses. It is quirky and individual. And so if people like it, that's great. Take what you want, but you know, it's not for everyone.
So this is a piece I just finished. This is one I've been thinking about doing for a long time. And so it started out as a painting. What I ended up with is a stained glass piece in a very elaborate frame, basically. So you have here pride, gluttony, lust, sloth, envy, greed, and then here in the office you have wrath. So I built this entire frame without really knowing for sure exactly what the rooms would look like. In a lot of important ways, it's just built as I go along. I mean, art can be a lot of things, and it can be just the way you live your life. I think that's probably the best art project, you know, just living your life with some kind of style. As far as objects, if you're talking about paintings and, or what I would call real art, is a painting that you see, just that makes you look at the world in a different way. You almost see the world the way the artist does. The artists I really like can do that.